Hello Frank, welcome to the abstract algebra class. It is class 46. In this class we will prove a theorem with theorem 6 and theorem 7. If G is a group and H is a subgroup of index 2 in G, then H is a normal subgroup of G. If G is a group of, and H is a subgroup of index 2 in G, then H is a normal subgroup of G. It means the left cosine or right cosine are 2. Proof. Let G be a group and H be a subgroup of G of index 2. Since index of H is equal to 2, then the number of distinct right cosine of H in G is equal to the number of distinct left cosine of H in G. It is equal to 2. 2 shows that the number of right cosine or left cosine of a subgroup. Let X belongs to G, then the right cosine of H or H comma HX, 2 left cosine, 2 right cosine. H is a right cosine or left cosine because we can write this EH, it is left cosine. HE, it is right cosine. The left cosine of H or H comma XH. H we count as the left cosine or right cosine. In both, H can be right cosine or left cosine as I wrote here. Since X belongs to G and H is a subgroup of G, then X belongs to H or X is not belongs to H. There is two conditions. X belongs to G and H is a subgroup of G. Then X may be belongs to H or X is not belongs to H. First we assume that X belongs to H. Then X belongs to H. It is implies if and only if XH equal to H equal to HX. If X is a subgroup of H, X belongs to H, then the right cosine and left cosine are equal. This implies X into H equal to H into X. This implies H is a normal subgroup of G. Second one, let X is not belongs to H, then H and HX are distinct. It means they don't have any joint element. H intersection HX equal to empty set. And H and XH are distinct. H intersection XH equal to also equal to empty set. When two set are distinct, then the intersection of them are empty set. Since H comma XH and H comma HX are distinct, then G equal to H union XH and G equal to H union HX. They are distinct, but then the union of them are equal to G. This implies X equal G equal to H union XH, H union left cosine, or H equal to G equal to H union right cosine. From this we can conclude that X into H equal to H into X. This implies H is a normal subgroup of G. Hence, proof of the theorem. We said that if G is a group and H is a subgroup of index 2 in G, then H is a normal subgroup of G. Then we prove that H is a normal subgroup of G. Left cosine and right cosine are equal. Theorem 7. A normal subgroup of a group G is commutative with every complex of G. A normal subgroup of a group G is commutative with every complex of G. We know the definition of complex. Every subset of a set G is complex of G. Proof. Let G be a group and N be a normal subgroup of G and H be a complex of G. We have to prove that in H equal to Hn. We say that normal subgroup with a complex or commutative. We can change the their places. And N is a normal subgroup. H is a complex. Then we can change the plus of H and N because they are commutative. Commutative. So N H equal to H L. We want to prove that N H equal to H N. Let N H belongs to N H. Where N belongs to N and H belongs to H. N H equal to, we can write H N to H N inverse N to N N to H. Because H N to H inverse equal E. Identity element. Identity element, we can, every element in H, we can multiply by an identity element. That is H into H inverse into N into H equal to NH belongs to NH. NH belongs to NH. We multiply by H into H inverse, then it is equal to NH, it is belongs to NH. This implies we take H outside of the bracket, H inverse into N into H belongs to HN. Here, see, H inverse into N into H, it is belongs to N. H belongs to H. This implies H into H inverse into N into H belongs to HN. It is H, it is N. Then the product of this is also belongs to HN. This implies NH. This is the value of NH. NH belongs to HN. Since NH belongs to NH, this implies NH belongs to HN. Here NH belongs to NH. But we prove that NH belongs to HN. This implies NH belongs to HN. This implies NH is subset of HN. Similarly, we can prove that HN is a subset of NH. From these two, we can write HN equal to NH, which is the result of the theorem. Hence, proof of the theorem. Thank you.